We are discussing about torque acting on a magnet placed in a uniform magnetic field. Torque acting on a magnet placed in a uniform magnetic field. This is our topic here. So as they mention here, it is a uniform magnetic field. First, let us draw the uniform magnetic field indication here. So let us see. The uniform magnetic field, I am drawing the vertical line, straight and parallel vertical lines I am drawing. This indicates uniform magnetic field, straight and parallel lines. Now what I am doing here is, I am taking the magnet and placing in the uniform magnetic field. I have taken one magnet and placed in this uniform magnetic field. Here we have two poles in a magnet. Here let me take, this is south pole and this one is north pole. The two poles of the magnet I have taken, and here the magnet is making an angle theta with the direction of field. B bar will give us the direction of magnetic field. B bar is the direction of magnetic field, and theta is the angle. What is theta here? Theta is angle between the magnetic field and magnet. Here, what is magnetic movement? So magnetic movement, capital M, I can write it as small m into 2L, you know that one. And what is magnetic length? Magnetic length is nothing but the distance between south pole to north pole. Let me take it as 2L. Now we have to observe, whenever a pole is there, is placed in magnetic field, the south pole will experience, this is the south pole you can observe here, the south pole will experience the magnetic force opposite to the field direction. South pole experience magnetic force opposite to the field direction. And north pole will experience magnetic force in the same direction of field, that is F equal to small m into B. Small m is pole strength, B is magnetic field. It is a uniform magnetic field, everything is uniform. So here also magnetic field is B, here also magnetic field is B. So here a magnetic length is 2L. So south pole will experience force always opposite to magnetic field. North pole will experience force in the same direction of magnetic field. Why means, we can say that always magnetic lines of force are directed from north to south. North to south. So here you observe carefully here, magnetic lines of force are directed from where to where, we are saying north to south. Here what pole is there? South pole is there. So south pole will attract towards north. North is down, so south pole attracts towards north. And your north pole will attract towards south, So the north pole will experience force in the direction of magnetic field, and south pole will experience force in opposite direction to the magnetic field, because the lines are given, arrow marks are above. See here, arrow marks showing up. Arrow marks are showing up means magnetic field is directed from down to top. So south pole experience force in opposite direction to the magnetic field. North pole experience the magnetic force in same direction of magnetic field. You have to be very clear with that idea, beta. That was repeated number of times. Now our target is, what is torque? We can write the torque formula as, one of the force into perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance between the two forces. When you take a couple, couple means, what do you mean by couple? Two forces are acting opposite and equal, but not at the same point, they're acting opposite and equal on the body, but not at the same point. Then the formula for torque, we can give it as, one of the force, the forces are equal here, one of the force into perpendicular distance between the forces. Perpendicular distance between the forces means I can write R. So you can observe clearly, this R is perpendicular. R is perpendicular distance to the forces. So tau is equal to F into R, we can write. So this is whenever you take any couple. Couple means the two forces act opposite and equal. So when two forces opposite and equal but not at same point, they are acting at different points. One here, other one here. They are acting opposite and equal. Opposite and equal. Then they will try to rotate the body. They will try to rotate the body like that. So when they try to rotate the body here, the torque acting is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. Force into perpendicular distance. Okay, leave it about this one. Now, coming to our diagram. What we mentioned here. In this one, how to handle the situation, we'll observe now. Here, if you observe, this is the magnet. Observe carefully. This is the magnet, south pole, north pole. And here what happened? One force is acting upward. One force is acting upward at north. At south, it is acting downward. So here, this is the length is 2L. But 2L now, it is not a 2L is now. Clearly observe here. From here to here, magnetic length I mentioned as 2L. 2L is magnetic length. So 2L is not perpendicular to the force directions. So we can't say 2L is perpendicular. Clearly it is not perpendicular to direction of force. But according to the definition of torque, what I've given for a couple is a one of the force into perpendicular distance. So I want perpendicular distance, but 2L is not perpendicular distance. 2L you can't observe as a perpendicular. So what I am doing means small construction I am doing here to get the perpendicular distance. You observe carefully now. Now in this triangle, first of all, one more thing I have to mention. This is the direction of field. This is the direction of field. This is the direction of magnetic field. And we told this angle is theta. This angle is theta means obviously what will happen? The opposite angles are equal and this angle is also theta. You have to accept that one. From maths, you know that. So this is the field direction. It is making an angle theta here. Obviously, opposite angles are equal. This angle theta means this angle is also theta. So these two angles are equal here. And from that information, now I am getting one triangle here. Right angle triangle. Let me place here one point P and clearly you can observe this S2P is perpendicular. S2P is perpendicular. So torque is equal to what we can write here. What's the formula? Force into perpendicular distance. Okay. Perpendicular distance. I'm writing simply perpendicular. Okay, beta. So tau is equal to what we have? Force into perpendicular distance. Okay, force value, we know. What is the force value? Means we can write Fe, one of the force. Both are equal anyhow. So, Fe is equal to Mb. Now, our target is to find what? Our target is to find torque. Torque we have to find. So, torque means force into perpendicular distance. Now, we have to discuss about perpendicular distance. Then we can get torque. So, how to get perpendicular distance? Clearly, in this triangle, you observe this S2P, It is perpendicular to direction of force F here. And also perpendicular direction of force F here. So SP is perpendicular distance. SP is perpendicular distance for the two directions of forces. SP is perpendicular. SP you can clearly observe it is perpendicular. So now what is perpendicular distance means SP? In this triangle, can you say one thing better? What is sine theta? What is sine theta from the triangle? Observe carefully here. This angle is theta. This angle is theta. Sine theta means opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite is perpendicular. Hypotenuse is 2L. Hypotenuse is 2L. See here, this angle is theta, no beta. Sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. I can write perpendicular by 2L. I can write it as perpendicular by 2L. From that information, I can write sine theta is equal to perpendicular by 2L. I can write here. So now, observe carefully here what we can write. Perpendicular is equal to, I can write 2L sine theta. Perpendicular is equal to 2L sine theta. So I got the value of perpendicular. I know the value of force. Now my target is to find the torque. Torque is force into perpendicular distance. From here, I notice, see this expression, sine theta is equal to perpendicular by 2L I got. From that expression, clearly I can observe perpendicular, because sine theta opposite by hypotenuse, I got perpendicular by 2L. Perpendicular is 2L sine theta. Now, what is about the formula for torque? Let us observe now. Torque is nothing but, what is torque beta? Force into perpendicular distance. Force into perpendicular distance. Here, force F is equal to, I can write, EMB. And perpendicular distance, just now I got it as 2L sine theta. 2L sine theta. Here, tau is equal to, I can write, MB into 2L sine theta. This is the expression I can write. Now observe carefully, beta. We know small m into 2L. What is small m into 2L, beta? Yes, small m pole strength, 2L magnetic length. Pole strength into magnetic length is called as magnetic movement. Magnetic movement. So now I can write the expression as tau is equal to, instead of this small m and 2L, I am writing it as what? Capital M. So tau is equal to capital MB sine theta. Tau is equal to MB sine theta. This is my expression for torque acting on a magnet placed in a uniform magnetic field. So I hope you are clear now. What we did here? This is the magnetic field we kept in the torque. That means you have to find the torque when a magnet is placed in the magnetic field. I placed here, south pole, north pole. North pole will experience force in upward. South pole experience downward. So that they will try to turn the magnet like this. So they are turning the magnet and the magnet is making an angle theta. So with the direction of magnetic field. And we notice that tau is equal to what we got? MB sine theta. Here, what is capital M? Capital M is magnetic movement. It's nothing but pole strength into magnetic length. This is the formula we got. And in vector form, because torque is a vector, we can write it as tau bar is equal to M bar cross B bar. MB sine theta is there. In vector form, we can write it as tau bar is equal to M bar cross B bar. So this is the vector form for torque. Tau bar is equal to M bar cross B bar. Now, suppose if you are taking here one note point, if theta is equal to 90, if theta is equal to 90 means, then that is the field and magnet are perpendicular. Field and magnet are perpendicular. Then what will happen? Sine 90 is 1. Sine 90 is 1. Tau is equal to MB sine 90. So we are getting sine 90 1 means the torque acting is maximum. Because maximum torque formula is MB. Maximum torque formula is MB. So we can write the maximum torque acts when field is in this direction, magnet in this direction, perpendicular, the torque acting on a magnet is maximum. Torque acting on the magnet is maximum. This is the discussion what we made. I'll show you the three pages what we discussed here. This is the first page of the diagram, what we got. And here, torque formula I have written. And again, I derived the torque formula here, tau equal to MB sine theta. And finally, we have written the torque form in the vector form, as well as we discussed about the maximum torque. Maximum torque. Like that, we discuss the torque acting on a magnet placed in a uniform magnetic field.